Stealing Your Heart. Chapter 6: Three People Depending on One Another. Zhong Jingha frowned, feeling deceived. And you had already woken up to prepare breakfast in the living room. When she saw Lin Xinyan sitting on the sofa alone in her pajamas, she smiled and asked, "Did you sleep well last night?" She thought Zhong Jingha would stay with Bai Dru Wei and would not come back last night. However, she heard some noises during the night. As she got up to check what happened, she saw that Zhong Jingha had returned and slept in his room. This was the wife chosen for the young master by his mother. And she was certainly good. And Yu, who had always been taking care of the young master, felt happy to see him finally got married. Her tone and expression were too enthusiastic and inexplicably intimate. Lin Xinyan gave a rigid smile and replied, "I slept quite well. Then let us go and change your clothes quickly. I will prepare breakfast and you can eat soon," Aunt Yu said as she walked into the dining room and started to make breakfast. Lin Xinyan looked down at her pajamas and the clothes she brought were still in the room. The man inside the room should have gotten dressed by now. Shouldn't he? She stood up and walked towards the bedroom. As she stood at the door, she raised her hand and knocked on the door. No one answered. She knocked again, but there was still no response. Having no other alternatives, she tried pushing the door. It was not locked from the inside and the door opened as soon as she pushed it. The moment the door was opened, she was hit with a cold atmosphere that was like winter in December, swept by the chills from the icy wind that made her shiver. The man was sitting on the edge of the bed as he stared coldly at a piece of paper. That paper. Soon after, Lin Xinyan saw what he was holding in his hand clearly and saw a mess on the floor. A sense of humiliation of being spied on and her privacy being invaded rushed into her. She ran into the room and snatched the paper. "How could you? You went through other people's things without their consent. Do you understand what privacy is?" "Ha ha," Zhong Jingha sneered. "Privacy." His false smile looked particularly scary. "You married me while carrying a bastard in your belly. How dare you talk about privacy now?" I, Lin Xinyan wanted to explain, but she could not find a suitable explanation at that moment. Zhong Jingha stood up. His steps were neither hurried nor slow, and they were especially rhythmic. Every step was like the atmospheric pressure closing in. Dark clouds tumbled over his sharp eyebrows. "Tell me, what is your motive?" Was she planning to make him raise someone else's child without knowing, and let the child become the eldest grandson of the Zhong family? Was the previous deal just an expedient of hers? The more he thought about it, the more his face sank. Lin Xinyan pursed her lips as her body trembled. She kept moving back, guarding her abdomen with her hands, for fear that he would hurt the child inside her. "I didn't mean to hide this from you. Since our marriage was just a transaction, I didn't tell you about it. There was absolutely no motive." Zhong Jingha's tone was inexplicably creepy and intimidating. "Really?" Lin Xinyan guarded her lower abdomen as she withdrew calmly, holding onto her composure. She said, "It's true. How can such a matter be bluffed through? If I have any improper thoughts, I'll suffer a painful death. Besides, if I really deceived you, I think you have the means to crush me, don't you?" Although her movements were very subtle, Zhong Jingha still noticed them as his gaze swept past the abdomen that she was protecting. His gaze was fixed on her face. "Why didn't you explain it clearly in the beginning?" Zhong Jingha did not believe her so easily. Her hands guarded her abdomen as they clenched tightly. Being pregnant with this child was too unexpected for her, but this was her family member related to her by blood. She had lost her brother, so she wished to give birth to this child. From now on, it could be like the past. The three of them can depend on one another. Thinking of that night, she could not help but tremble with cold sweat on her palms. I just found out not long ago. She didn't even dare to tell Zhuang Zijin that she didn't dare to put the checkup list in the hospital because she was afraid that Zhuang Zijin would find it. She didn't expect to cause such a big disturbance. And caused Zhong Jingho to suspect her of having impure motives. She was only 18 years old. And she actually. How promiscuous was her private life? Zhong Jingho's face was extremely gloomy when he warned her. You better behave yourself during this month. If I find out that you stir any trouble. No, I absolutely won't. I'll behave myself, and if I overstep the mark, I'll leave myself at your disposal. Lin Xinyan promised quickly. Even if she could not gain his trust, she must not make him doubt her motives. She was already in a difficult situation. And if she got one more enemy, it would be disadvantageous for her to regain her things. Zhong Jingho stared at her, looking closely, as if he was judging the credibility of her words. Clang, clang, Auntie Chen came over at this moment. Breakfast is ready. Zhong Jingho narrowed his gaze and restrained his anger. Clean up the floor. After that, he turned around and left the room. As soon as Zhong Jingho left, Lin Xinyan's legs became weak. She leaned on the low cabinet behind her and took a long time to regain her strength. Then she crouched down and picked up the clothes that were scattered on the floor. When she saw the baby's ultrasound scan in her hand, tears rolled down her face and dripped on the paper. She wiped her face. She should not cry, as it was a sign of weakness. She must not be weak, since her mother and the child in her belly needed her. She folded the paper and put it in her bag. Then she changed her clothes and left the room. There was no one in the dining room. Also, there were empty coffee cups and empty plates on the dining table. He probably had finished eating and left. Lin Xinyan breathed a sigh of relief. It felt really repressive spending time with that man. Then she went to the dining table and ate. After breakfast, she went out as she told Zhuang Zijin that she was going back. She was also afraid that Zhuang Zijin would be worried about her. As soon as she entered the door, she was held back by Zhuang Zijin, who asked, "The eldest master of the Zhong family." "Mom," Lin Xinyan's tone was very serious, as she did not want to say more about this. "He's a very good man. Don't worry about me." Zhuang Zijin sighed. Her daughter, who had grown up, had her own opinions and did not like to hear too much nagging. Zhuang Zijin could not help but felt a sense of loss. "I cared about you." She was worried that he would treat her daughter badly. Lin Xinyan hugged her. She did not mean it. But confronting Zhong Jingho and trying hard to convince him had drained her to the point of exhaustion. "Mom, I'm just a little tired and I didn't mean it." "I know. I didn't blame you." Zhuang Zijin stroked her back. She seemed to be able to feel her exhaustion. "If you are tired, sleep and rest for a while." Lin Xinyan nodded. Although she did not want to sleep, she felt exhausted indeed. Subsequently, she fell asleep after she went to the bedroom. At noon, Zhuang Zijin finished preparing lunch and asked her to wake up and eat. Sitting on the dining table, Zhuang Zijin served rice to her daughter. "I cooked fish. That's your favorite." Zhuang Zijin felt guilty towards her daughter. Although she gave birth to Lin Xinyan, she failed to provide her with a happy childhood and let her suffer. Lin Xinyan glanced at the sweet and sour fish prepared by her mother on the table. It had a faint sweet and sour aroma. It used to be her favorite dish, but now, it turned her stomach upside down when she smelled it. She could not hold back. "Ugh, Yan," covering her mouth. Lin Xinyan did not have time to explain. She went straight into the bathroom and retched while leaning on the side of the sink. Zhuang Zijin was worried and came along. Being someone who had given birth before, her face turned slightly pale when she saw her daughter's reaction. However, she did not believe it, as her daughter was very conservative and honest. And she never had a boyfriend at school. She is someone with moral integrity. Zhuang Zijin's voice trembled a little. "Yan, what's wrong with you?" Lin Xinyan's body suddenly stiffened. Her hands clasped tighter and tighter onto the edge of the sink. Since she decided to keep this child, Zhuang Zijin would need to know sooner or later. She turned to look at her mother and mustered her courage. Mom, I'm pregnant. Zhuang Zijin could not steady herself for a moment and stepped back. She could not believe this. Her daughter was just 18. Welcome, download Bravonovel app to continue reading Stealing Your Heart novel.